What's up, everybody? Gen X Dividend Investor here. In this video, I'm going to reveal the top 10 dividend stocks for January that investors on my Dividend Discord chat server voted that they're buying or plan to buy. But before I get to that, I have to share this breaking news as of January 1st. It looks like if you click on my M1 referral link in the description of this video and then open a new non-retirement brokerage account and you transfer some cash into it, then we both get $30 for free. I've never seen M1 offer $30 before, so I'm guessing it'll only last for January of 2021, so act now. It's literally free cash. Of course, read up on the details when you sign up as they could change it at any time. Okay, each month I run this top 10 stocks poll and I've gotten hundreds of votes. As I review the results of the votes, I'll also be sharing my perspective on if I agree or disagree or whatever. Then I'll end this video with a powerful life story that is worth hearing and reflecting on, so I recommend you watch this entire video. Please consider hitting the thumbs up button, subscribing if you haven't yet, and click that bell notification. Now, before we start, I have to share this hilarious meme that a user on my Discord named Trans shared, which cracked me up. The first picture shows Jennifer Lawrence sitting across from Chris Pratt, and she says, "I like men who take risks." And then the second pic is where he responds with, "I don't do any research on the stocks I buy." And then the final picture is of her in his lap making out with him. So for you cowboys that just hit that buy button on your smartphone without knowing much more than the ticker, I'm confident you'll be hooking up with JLo version 2 soon. Okay, let's jump into it. The 10th most popular stock in the poll with 27% of voters is a favorite sin stock of many dividend investors out there, and that's Altria, ticker MO. Altria has a consensus analyst rating of a buy and a crazy 51 consecutive years of dividend increases. They have a monstrous 8.45% yield and a strong 3-year dividend CAGR of 10.4%. Now, the payout ratio and the PE that are getting dynamically pulled are incorrect. I believe their PE is around 10 and their payout ratio is around 79%, which is normally high for most companies, but not for tobacco stocks like Altria, which have honed their business to be able to run it a bit hot like that. Altria is about $41 a share, below their 52-week high of about $52, and above their 52-week low of about $31. If you're interested in hearing my thoughts on investing in sin stocks, then watch my video called Millionaire Dividend Investing Questions and Answers for November. Oh, I thought this was funny to share. It's two new articles that just appeared on Seeking Alpha, one of which is saying why Altria is collapsing and another explaining why it isn't. I guess this just reinforces that one person's trash is another person's treasure, and even the more educated opinions can think different things about a stock. To me, it's obvious that smoking is on an ongoing decline in many places around the world, but tobacco still remains a cash cow. Altria has been diversifying into other areas such as MJ, vaping, beer and such, while still pushing their 800-pound revenue gorilla. If you're looking for some yield now, then Altria may be worth considering at these prices. Okay, the 9th most popular stock in the poll with 28% of voters is a favorite REIT amongst many dividend investors, and that's none other than Realty Income, ticker O, which is my 10th largest position in my dividend portfolio. O has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, recently became a dividend aristocrat with their 25 consecutive years of dividend increases, have a nice 4.61% yield, and a mediocre 3-year dividend CAGR of 4.26%. Watch my Realty Income video if you want to learn why traditional metrics such as payout ratio, PE ratios, and EPS are not a reliable way to estimate the value of a REIT. So professional analysts often use a measure called Adjusted Funds from Operations, or AFFO, to estimate a REIT's value as it represents their true residual cash flow and is often a better predictor of a REIT's future ability to pay dividends. We can see that for the 9 months ending in September, Realty Income's Funds from Operations increased substantially, as did their FFO per share and their AFFO and AFFO per share. During the third quarter of 2020, the company distributed around $242 million in common dividends to stockholders, representing 85.7% of their AFFO of $282.5 million. Now, beyond those metrics, it's also good to look at rent collection, and we see that in the last few months they're hovering slightly over 93%, which is an improvement over what they hit in July when they were at 91.8%. If we look at their top 20 tenants as of September and try to identify areas of potential risk, then I'd imagine cinemas might be problematic, and we see that Regal Cinemas and AMC are a combined 5.5% of revenue, so not too bad. They also have some tenants which seem very strong, like 7-Eleven, Dollar General, Walmart, Kroger, and Home Depot. One question mark area for me would be pharmacies like Walgreens and CVS. I think that brick and mortar pharmacies have value, but I wonder how Amazon's new online pharmacy will eat into them. Full disclosure, I'm long Amazon, and I just use their online pharmacy, and once you're set up, it's really awesome. You can see prices for meds with versus without your insurance, and they freaking deliver them to your doorstep like there are other products. So if Amazon kicks ass like they normally do when they go into a new business vertical, then I'd be wary of brick and mortar pharmacies. I know some of those brick and mortars deliver meds in the mail, but consolidating your purchasing into Amazon is sweet. Though one downside is it's a different URL. Anyways, let's take a look at Realty Income's price movement over the last 12 months. O is currently about $61 a share, well below their 52-week high of $85 and above their 52-week low of $38. I personally like investing in O at these levels given my risk tolerances and goals. Okay, the 8th most popular stock in the poll with 29% of voters has my favorite soda in the world, which is Diet Coke. And of course I'm talking about one of Warren Buffett's most famous investments, which is Coca-Cola. Coke is actually my 8th largest position in my dividend portfolio. Coke has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, are a dividend king at 58 consecutive years of dividend increases, have a high 83% payout ratio, probably due to the pandemic, have a decent 3.03% yield, a 5.57% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a 28 PE. Coke is currently about $54 a share, well below their 52-week high of $85 and above their 52-week low of about $38. Coke seems a bit spendy at these levels. I'd personally like to see something under $45 to get more excited. Okay, the 7th most popular stock in the poll with 30% of voters is Apple, which is my largest position by market value in my dividend portfolio. Apple has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, or 10 consecutive years of dividend increases, have an awesome low 24% payout ratio, have a crappy 0.61% yield because the stock has shot up so much, have an awesome 10.5% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a high 48 PE. Apple is currently about $135 a share, which is basically at their 52-week high of $138, and are way, way above their 52-week low of $53. Apple is too rich for me at these prices, but Apple has seemed too expensive for me for a long time, so I've never been good at nailing down a reasonable price, DCF or not. Okay, the 6th most popular stock in the poll with 32% of voters is JP Morgan Chase, ticker JPM. Oftentimes people ask me why I don't own stock X or stock Y, and my answer is that there are a ton of awesome stocks out there that I don't own, due to a slew of reasons. JPM has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, a decent 10 consecutive years of dividend increases, a strong 47% payout ratio, a slightly low 2.88% yield, a very nice 3-year dividend CAGR of 16%, and a PE of 16. It can be useful to look at price to book value when analyzing a bank, as can net interest margins, efficiency ratios, and return on average asset metrics, amongst others. By the way, the screen you see here is coming from my best dividend stock spreadsheet portfolio tracker 2.0, which is free to my Patreon aristocrats and kings. JPM's at $125 a share, below the 52-week high of $141 and above their 52-week low of about $77. While JPM isn't as compelling to me as it was under $100, I still find it decently attractive as a generational play. Okay, the 5th most popular stock in the poll with 36% of voters is 3M, ticker MMM, which is my favorite industrial stock that I'm long in, which is my 7th largest position by portfolio value. 3M has a consensus analyst rating of a hold, are a dividend king at an amazing 62 consecutive years of dividend increases, have a 68% payout ratio, a nice 3.38% yield, a good 9.06% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a decent 20 PE. 3M is at $174 a share, below the 52-week high of $182 and well above their 52-week low of about $114. 3M is a bit spendy here, but I can't fault people for going in. Okay, the 4th most popular stock in the poll with 37% of voters is AbbVie, ticker ABBV, which is one of my favorite healthcare stocks, second to J&J, and which is my 15th largest position in my dividend portfolio. AbbVie has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, are either at 54 consecutive years of dividend increases or at 7, depending if you count their time with Abbott. FinViz has their payout ratio at 100%, Seeking Alpha has it at 50%. Let's calculate it manually. Payout ratio is dividends per share divided by EPS. I'll use forward EPS. Some people like trailing, it just depends on what you're going for. So their dividends per share per year is $5.20, and their forward EPS is $10.49. So it looks like Seeking Alpha was correct. It's pretty common to find data issues all over the place, including Seeking Alpha, so if you're really concerned, then go to the investor relations portion of a business and look at their financials. AbbVie has a tasty 4.97% yield, an incredible 3-year dividend CAGR of 20.86%, and a PE of 23. AbbVie is at $105.55 a share, below the 52-week high of $109 and well above their 52-week low of about $62. Even at these prices, I like AbbVie. Watch my deep analysis video if you want to learn about some more pros and cons of AbbVie. Okay, on to the top 3. So the 3rd most popular stock in the poll with 39% of voters needs no introduction, and of course I'm talking about J&J, ticker J&J. No wait, I should say Johnson & Johnson, ticker J&J. If you don't know what J&J is and you're watching this, then you probably meant to click on that dancing cat video and accidentally clicked on mine and you only got to this point because you fell asleep. Well, if that's the case, I hope you have wonderful dreams of J&J bouncing through your noggin. J&J has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, are a dividend king with an amazing 58 consecutive years of dividend increases, have a 6% payout ratio, a low 2.62% yield, an okay 5.98% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a 24 PE. J&J is $156 a share, below the 52-week high of 157 and well above their 52-week low of about 109. J&J is basically at their all-time high, but I don't hold it against people for investing in quality, even if it's spendy. That being said, smarter investors would probably wait for a pullback. J&J happens to be my third largest position in my dividend portfolio. Okay, the second most popular stock in the poll with 42% of voters is known for making the Halo franchise, the Azure cloud, and the Windows operating system, and of course I'm talking about Microsoft. Microsoft has a consensus analyst rating of a buy, have a strong 17 consecutive years of dividend increases, have an awesome 32.6% payout ratio, a very low 1% yield, a great 10% 3-year dividend CAGR, and a bit of a high PE at 35. Microsoft is at $222 a share, below the 52-week high of 233 and well above their 52-week low of about 132. I can't bring myself to invest more in Microsoft at these levels, but hey, the analysts say it's a buy, so what do I know? Okay, the number one most popular stock in the poll with 44% of voters is a well-known communication services company, and I'm talking about AT&T, ticker T. T has a consensus analyst rating of a hold, have an amazing 35 consecutive years of dividend increases, a payout ratio according to Seeking Alpha of 66%, an amazing 7.29% yield, a very low 3-year dividend CAGR of 2.04%, and a nice 18.7 PE. AT&T has some real debt issues, which management is attempting to pay off, but they could take a big step backwards given the 5G auction that's going on. The debt issue with AT&T is a big deal, which is why the stock has been beaten down. That combined with some subjectively bad acquisitions coupled with decades of non-performance in the stock. I'm fine taking a calculated risk investing at these levels, but you need to realize that I'm also fine with the very real downside potential. Do not invest unless you understand that. If you want a safer play with what I'd argue is less upside, then consider Verizon. They're a great company, and while they have material debt, it's less than AT&T's. T is at $28 a share, below the 52-week high of 39 and above the 52-week low of 26. I personally like T at these prices, but I'm okay with the risk. Now, beyond those stocks, I think it's interesting to also consider oil stocks. I think oil is a risky play, but I also think there's a reasonable medium-term stock appreciation play, along with a shorter-term risk of a dividend cut. Watch my top 5 oil dividend stocks video to hear some more nuanced thoughts of mine. Okay, now I'm going to switch gears and tell you a valuable story about life I found online that's worth hearing and reflecting on. This is about focusing on the good things in life. Two friends were walking through the desert. At one stage of their journey, they had an argument and one friend slapped the other in the face. The one who got slapped was hurt, but without saying anything, he wrote in the sand, "Today my best friend slapped me in the face." They kept on walking until they found an oasis, where they decided to have a wash. The one who had been slapped got stuck in a mire and started drowning, but his friend saved him. After he recovered from the shock, he wrote on a stone, "Today my best friend saved my life." The friend who slapped and saved his best friend asked him, "After I hurt you, you wrote in the sand, and now you write in stone. Why?" The other friend replied, "When someone hurts us, we should write it down in sand where winds of forgiveness can erase it away. But when someone does something good for us, we must engrave it in stone where no wind can ever erase it." That story is one I've been thinking about a lot lately. I got in a fight with a relative who I used to be close to, and now our relationship is strained. I need to tell myself to focus on the good of our relationship and not the bad. Okay, moving on. Now I want to show you something awesome that someone ordered by clicking on my Amazon affiliate link and then going shopping online. As an Amazon associate, I earned from qualifying purchases. So someone awesome ordered this sweet sushi coat. I'm not sure who, because Amazon doesn't share those details with me, but whoever you are, I'm sure you are now looking sushi-rific. So if that was you, leave me a comment down below so I can thank you. Okay, now I'd like to shout out my higher tier Patreons who have signed up since my last video. So my first thank you goes out to Europe13. And then I'd also like to thank Elgato for signing up. I'd also like to thank Banks27. I'd also like to thank Just Wheeling. And I'd like to thank Brown Jesus. I'd also like to thank Austin B. And finally, I'd like to thank Chauncey J. As an aristocrat, they gain access to my new Dividend Spreadsheet 2.0 product and to multiple private channels on my Discord, including one where I let people watch my videos before I release them to the public, as well as vote on some thumbnails I use in my videos, as well as get direct access to me. And I'd like to thank you, the viewer, for watching all the way to the end. It really means the world to me. Please consider hitting the thumbs up button, subscribing if you haven't yet, and click that bell notification. Finally, I highly recommend that you join my free Dividend Discord chat server, which has thousands of dividend investors on it and is growing all the time. Have a happy and safe new year, and I'll talk to you again real soon.
I am not a financial advisor, and these videos are for entertainment, inspiration, and educational purposes only. Investing of any kind involves risk. I am only sharing my opinion with no guarantee of gains or losses on investments.